Need some ventilation, a little vacation. Used to fornication. Mind redefine new renovations. Space.
Yo guys, what is up? Welcome to the video. Today we got something brand new. Now, Showcase Sunday usually is just me showing off a brand new weapon or a new game mode map, something. And usually my audio is at a bare minimum. You guys can barely hear me. I've noticed in my other videos. So I've decided, why not I bring my green screen here and I bring my gun here. That way the audio is nice, crisp, and you got a nice visual right here. So today's weapon of the day, Cerberus+1 auto rifle. Now I got this last night. I feel so proud of myself. But what I want you to know here is the stats, how it is against other exotic auto rifles, and how it overall performances. So, as you can see, we have the gun right here. We got the Cerberus+1, beautiful weapon. I love it. It looks really nice because it gives you an authentic feel. It's like, wow, the barrels and everything was actually put together. You can see a battery on the side of it, a strap going down around it, the three barrels in the middle one just being inserted there. And the lore is pretty funny because that's actually what it matches up to. That's what the lore tries to tell you, that's how it was created by a guardian who found scraps of auto rifles that were destroyed by Fallen. And he decided to put them together, make one monster. So I think that was a great idea for Bungie to add something like this. But let's take a look at what we got here. Impact, we got low impact. That's because this is a shotgun auto rifle. And now, most of you may not know what that is. Shotgun auto rifle, well, this is primarily one of the only ones I've noticed to be like this. Shotgun auto rifles are auto rifles that have low impact, but their fire rates and their magazine sizes are high enough so that when you're up against someone, like when you have four barrels, you really don't need to stay far and try to shoot them. Just go up close. Especially when the shots here can fire anywhere. Like, as you can see here in this screenshot I took, the shots are in triangles. They're in triangle formations. Fourth shot is always out somewhere random. And that's only because if you don't aim down sights, it really does mess it up because the shots are spread out everywhere. And you have shot package on this, which was a D1 perk. Useful for shotguns, they removed it because that was really OP. Now for this gun, you do need it because of the barrels. The range is okay, but that's because you're not supposed to like camp with it, you're supposed to be up close. The whole goal, again, shotgun auto rifle. The rest of the stuff, it makes sense of why it is the way it is, because of how it is. So it's like, if this wasn't such a close range weapon, you could actually go ahead and use it from anywhere. Like, most people like to camp with a bow or hide with a sniper. You could just hide with this thing if it wasn't the way it is. Magazine size, you got 31. Not bad, because your overall reserves can go up to 489 around. So you can get almost 500 bullets out of this gun. And keep in mind, one bullet equals four shots, so it's not like you're wasting four shots altogether. That would be really ridiculous. And then you have its rate of fire, which 320, I think that's pretty good considering the nature of this weapon. Compared to a hard light, sweet business, I would prefer this weapon just because of how powerful it can be. Sweet business, one of my favorite weapons. Now, why I haven't actually used it too much ever since I got this weapon is because the sweet business, sure, it's great for taking down hordes of ads and stuff like that. When it comes to fighting bosses, not really the best idea. All because of its recoil. That's a lot of recoil on that weapon. I'm trying to work for the Catalyst. Once I get it, you'll see a video on that soon. But the Cerberus+1, I think it's a great addition, and once they start adding in Catalyst for the Forsaken weapons, I feel like this is going to have a really nice buff, either to impact, reload speed, or just like stability, because stability or handling, because judging by the way it is, you need more of that than you do anything else. Now, let's see how this works in missions. I'm going to show you two variances of this. One is a mission where you're a lower light, and one where you're scaled or higher to all the enemies. Because one I did with the Shattered Throne, which was a 590 light mission, and I was a 550. The other one we have here is going to be just a regular story mission that was heroic. Take a look. Alrighty then, so, as you can see, this thing can just tear up ads, especially when you're up against low-level enemies. What I really do want to emphasize is, this is more of a PvP weapon than anything. Just because it's a shotgun auto rifle, those types of things are used for PvP. Gambit, Crucible, Iron Banner, you name it. That's what it's for. Like, let's take a look. I'll show you guys a match of Rumble, Gambit, and a little bit of Quick Play. Let's take a look.
No sin. Heard they talking shit about I, who will win and why. I'm alive, just took one to revive. Keep that vibe when we show up and collide. Me and the guys move just like the FOI. In the hills, but still keep them ghetto ties. Was talking Frenchies, but she thinking Ocean Prime. No, she keep an open mouth and open mind. I don't open up a door, she open mind. I need less stress and I need more thighs, yeah. We on a jet quest, mobbing with the drive, yes. In the headrest, 1 of 25, yes. Ain't seen the best yet, open up your eyes, yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's the countdown till I slide. Walking rhymes, how I grew up on my side. Ain't no fence, just 100 acres wide.
Alrighty, so that was the Cerberus+1, guys. Next weapon, you never know what it could be. It could be the Wishender, it could be the Malfeasance, whatever I get. And if you guys have any weapon showcases you'd like me to do, let me know, and I'll see if I either have that weapon or I'll try and get that weapon. But this has been Ninja Chameleon. Peace out.